next part is about the concavity. The concavity of the function, there are two different types. The first one is called concave upward.
Concavity.
And the second one is concave downward.
Wait a second. Write something.
Are you okay, Min?
Yeah, just writing.
It's if you have the notes, is you just go along with it because it's in more detail on the guided notes. I just cannot use a lot of ink on the document. Okay, how do we determine the concave upward, concave downward? By definition, concave upward means if you have the curve. Okay, and then you draw the tangent line. Some use different color. The tangent line and the curve is above your tangent line. So this portion is called the interval of concave up or concave upward, either one. The shorter version is like just concave up, or the term is CU. Okay, concave up because this portion of the graph, the red curve is above the tangent line. And then the other portion, if you draw the tangent line and the curve is below, this is your tangent line. This portion is called concave downward. That's the definition of concave up or concave down. CU as a concave up, CD as a concave down. And with the notation, the derivative, that means the rate of change is decreasing, or the rate of change is increasing. Okay, for the upward, concave upward means the rate of change, which is the derivative of what? Of the slope. So the change in the slope is positive. For the concave down, the change of the slope is negative. And by the notation for the slope is y prime or the f prime. That means if you find the prime on top of the prime, which is the second derivative, if the second derivative is greater than zero, the graph concave upward. For the second derivative less than zero, the graph concave downward. That's the summary of the concavity. Concave upward, we check the derivative, the second derivative. If it's greater than zero, upward. For the second derivative less than zero, concave downward. Another way that I use to help my student, when you have the positive sign, when I have the positive sign, so I'm happy. If I have negative sign, I'm not happy. And the happy sign, if you pretend like you draw the line underneath it, so the graph is above my tangent line, similar to the way that I treat the second derivative less than zero, the graph is below. If the graph is above, upward, the graph below, downward. And I use a happy sign or unhappy sign to help me recognize the behavior as concave up or concave down. All right, so that's the concave up, concave down. And then the graph could have more than one behavior in one graph. So we're gonna determine which interval that the graph concave up, which interval concave down, by using the breaking point, similar to the critical point, the breaking from increasing to decreasing, or the other way around. So to find the point of the change from concave up to concave down, or from concave down to concave up, we call the point of concavity, or the point of inflection, sorry. So the next step, the next one is gonna be the point of inflection. Point of inflection, some textbook they use like POI, point of inflection. The inflection point or the point of inflection can be found by step number one, you find the second derivative. Okay, and then step two, you're gonna treat it similar way that you find the critical point by considering the case that f double prime equals zero or f double prime equals undefined. Gonna be one of these two cases or both cases at the same time, depends on the function that you have. Okay, and whatever the point that you get that gives the f double prime equals zero or f double prime undefined. So the point x here, for the critical value, that's the f prime, right? Just one prime. For the second prime, that's above and beyond. So this x is called the super critical point. Is that called super? Let me check. Hypercritical, sorry, wrong one. Let me erase this and then draw. So it's called the hypercritical. Like critical on top of the critical. Okay. That's the second step. And then the third step. The third step, we're gonna determine the interval. This is the S, so in the plural. For the case at F double prime positive or F double prime negative, recall the positive side, that means I'm happy, right? So that means I'm happy. Negative side, I'm not happy. Positive side gonna be the concave up interval. Negative side gonna be concave down. Okay, that's the way to determine. And then the point that's changing from one concave to another concave is called the point of inflection. So I'm gonna wrap up over here as the last step or step four. So point of inflection occurs when the side change from concave up to concave down or concave down to concave up. So the point that the side switched from one to another, that means the side of the F double prime. So four steps to identify the point of inflection.